Hi there, welcome to Teachers Tech. My name is Jamie, and it's great to have you here. Today, I want to show you how to use FigJam, a digital whiteboard by Figma. Now, recently, you might have heard that Google Jamboard is going to be discontinued in 2024. Even if it wasn't going to be discontinued, I would suggest that you'd make the switch over to FigJam. It's just the far superior digital whiteboard. And whether you be corporate or education, it can match so many solutions. If you're part of the education system, you can get this for free by signing up for an education account. So today, I want to show you how to use FigJam, the digital whiteboard. So where do you get FigJam? Well, I'll put the link to this down below in the description, and you can go ahead and just go try FigJam for free. I'll put another link if you are an educator. There will be this link also where you can sign up with your educator's account, and then you just need to get verified through that, then you'll have it for free. So a couple options for there. And once you try signing up, you'll see how easy it is. Just go ahead and click on this, for example. You can go get signed up with Google here, and then you'll get into the first screen and I'll explain what you're seeing. When you get logged in, you're going to see a screen like this. I just want to explain that you have access to a couple different things here. We have Figma and FigJam. FigJam is the whiteboard that I'm going to tell you about, but Figma is a design and prototyping program that is just fantastic that you also can be using. So if you wanted to design an app, how it looks and feel, or maybe a website, you can do that here. And I have a full different tutorial on that as well. I'll put a link to the card up top and down below in the description. But for us today, we're going to be dealing with a whiteboard. We can access the whiteboard right here with all these templates, but we're just going to start from a blank one, and we are going to go to FigJam board right here. So I'm just going to go ahead and click this, and right away I get a new board here. And once I'm in here, I can always go back. So if I go back over here and just click on this one, I can go back to files, and that brings me back here. Now, when I did that, this is the untitled board that I just did. I didn't even name it yet. And then I can go back to this one or even start a new FigJam board from here. But I'm just going to go ahead and open this one up again. And maybe I want to title it right away. I could go up and just click in here, and this will be my example, my demo up here. So now, how does this work? You're going to see that the options are very simple, but there's lots of them that you can be playing with. I want to go back up to the navigation again, right to the left here, the main menu. I just want to point out that if you go file, you can go from new FigJam file right to here, or design file with Figma. But this way you can have multiple different whiteboards open, and each of these will get saved. You can see this is a new one I haven't titled. You can close this down, but this would get saved in that main screen as well. The other thing I want to point out here in this main menu is to, if you want the desktop app, you can download this as well. You can even save your files locally. So just a couple different options if you wanted to go with that route too, but they work exactly the same whether you're just using online a browser. You can also be using this on an iPad or any device. You just need to log in through the web. Now, I just want to point out what you're seeing right here. These are templates, so they're just giving you a quick preview of templates. You can close this down here, and we'll go back to templates because we can always access the templates right up here, but we'll go back in a little bit because they do have some fantastic templates. I just want to start here with this right here, the main bar, to see all the different options that you have in here. So let's take a quick run through of the bar down here, looking at the quick tools you can use. So starting with our marker, as soon as you select it, you get the options to choose the marker. We also have a highlight here, but we can choose thick or thin, choose your color, choose a custom if you want, but try drawing with this. You can see how smooth and reactive it is. I have tested this out on a digital whiteboard as well. I'll put a little clip of me there working on it, and it worked very well just using my finger and everything. Everything worked pretty much the same as using it on my computer. So if you're in front of the classroom or at a business meeting, that can work well too. Now, just to go back to this right here, we have our selection tool. if the selection tool allows me to select everything that I want by drawing it around, I can make some changes if it was going to be color, or even I can change the lines thick or thin, and there's some alignment there as well. This tool over here is the hand tool. The hand tool allows me to grab the canvas and move it around. Speaking of the canvas, what I want to show you is how much space you have. Notice it's at 100% right now. If I zoom out to 2%, you can't hardly even see it. You have a lot of space to work with in FigJam. And again, go to the hand if you want to move it around. I'm going to go back to this tool because we have the eraser here. You can see how easy it is just to erase this way as well. We do have our washi tape here in different designs if you wanted to add some of these. So just some fun things also to have. All right, let's keep on moving with some of the other options we have. We have our shape tool. What I like, I'm going to zoom back out to 100%. When you add a shape, so if I add the shape, I can quickly change the shape. So if I wanted a different one, the other thing I can do is the colors are quick to add. And then I can go through and notice we have these hovers and these are connectors. So if I go and draw it this way, I can add another shape to it, make all those changes. I can add any text to these as well. Anytime I add text, I can add a link. I really like that with using FigJam. If you have an external link, you can just add it and away you go to whatever it be, maybe a video or a document, but I'm going to show you how you can embed those right inside FigJam as well. So that's a little bit about the shapes. Another great option are the sticky notes, and this is a pretty common thing, but what I like about it, if we go ahead and just drag one up, notice how my name goes on it right away. So it makes it a just kind of a nice way if someone's making a adding a sticky note, the name is there so you can see what people are adding to it. Now I'm going to jump over this. I'm going to come back to this because these are lots of fun plugins and widgets. I just want to talk about the text tool. Super easy to add. Click your text, draw your box, and just say what you want to. And again, make your customization of the font size bold. We can link anything like I showed you before. If you need more connectors, just like when I had the shape ones up here, they're here. So I can have a connector. As soon as I do that, notice as I hover over everything, I can start to connect wherever I want, start to draw these all around. We also can go with our straight ones there as well. The stamp tool, this is a fun thing because the stamp tool allows me to give some voting, some lifetime voting, because when you're working, you can share this. I'm going to show you in a moment. But if I go to the stamp tool, I can put different ideas up. And if I write something, then I can use these to find out how people are feeling about different things. So if I have this, I could add the thumbs up here. Maybe there's something else that is a thumbs down. You can put that so you can get some feedback right away by using those stamp tools. The section tool here. So if I go ahead and let's say I have this text over here, I'm just going to change back to my selection tool. If I have this, this right here, I can draw this. I'm going to draw this over. What this allows me to do, maybe I have a bunch of stuff underneath it. If I go and hide it, then if I don't want people to see it right away, I can do this. And I like that because then you can just hide it. And then when you want to reveal something, you can go ahead and do it that way. I can name this to what I want. You can name it up here. So you could have different sections where you're hiding and then showing as you go through. And lastly, we have our table here. Very simple. You can just click. And if you want to keep things clean in tables, you can just go through to the cells and add the text. So everything, again, works so easy. It's just when we're dragging and dropping these. Now for some fun things, I'm going to zoom out a bit. Take a look at all the different widgets and plugins that we have. So there's stickers, templates, widgets, plugins, and I'm not going to go through them all here, but just to show you all the different things that you can add through here. We even have dice if you want to roll some dice on here. We have icebreakers. Just go searching. So for an example, if I want this as a sticker, I can add it and move it around to where I want. This camera is kind of fun. So if I go and let's say I go to this camera, I plunk the Polaroid somewhere here, and I'm going to move it over here and hit this. Take a look at what happens here. Whoop, you can see the green screens behind me. I can click this. I can get ready for my smile. And it comes out. Look at that. And then, so if you were having a class or people are in different places, you could get people to take a picture of themselves and just at that point add it to the screen. So that's kind of a fun add-on to it. So go ahead and play with all these things and just let me know what you're thinking in the comments. But there, I want to move over to sharing and how easy that works. This is another thing I really love about FigJam is just how easy to share. So I'm going to go ahead and share this. I have two different browsers. I actually have Microsoft Edge on the left here, and on the right I have Google Chrome. I'm just going to click share up here. If I was going to be working with teams and adding whether it be other business people or students, I could add them through here. But the way I want to show you is you can see anyone with a link. And I could leave it to view or change it to edit. I can copy this. You notice that you can actually get the embed. But if I just jump over here, I'll just close this down and I'm just gonna paste this. So just Control V, paste it over and take a look at how easy this is. So now I'm not logged in. As I move my mouse on the right, on the left, you can see the hand move and it will say anonymous on it. If I click over here now, you can see on the other side that Jamie Keat comes because that's the side it's working on. So if I had a bunch of people that I'm sharing this, I get an idea what different people are doing. So if I'm over here and if I wanted them to edit, right now they can only have view. That's why they don't have that access. But you can go ahead and start playing with some of these options here, and it gives you an idea of what people are seeing on the other side. So just some easy sharing. And remember, this works with iPads and different, there's an app for that, that this will work too if you have multiple things happening in the classroom. All right, I want to show you a few more options now. Here's another thing that is so awesome about this whiteboard. I'm going to bring some things in. Let's start with a picture. I could go and up to the main menu and then I can go file, import, and I can pick whatever image I want. I can size it. I can crop all these great options and hit the check mark, and very easy to use. So I can add multiple ones. I can also go for my, let's say this right, if I go ahead and copy image and just go back to Figma here, I can just Control V and paste images right in. Notice it's just very easy with all those, even if I wanted a video. So here is my Figma video. So I could go Control C, copy this URL, come over here, Control V and paste. Now this video, I can, I'm gonna zoom in here so I can grab the side a little bit better. I can still size this here. So I can go ahead and expand it. And I have this video link that I can have right in here. So it's a quick way to bring videos. Other whiteboards, it just seems to be a little laggy when we do this, but I can hit play.
Hi there, welcome to Teachers Tech.
Right in here. So just some options that you can be bringing things in. But not only that, you can also bring in documents. So if I have a Google Doc, I could go and copy this URL, go back over here and just paste it again, and I have the document. You need to be logged in. So whether it be a Microsoft, if you're going into a Word document online, but here we go. I can expand this and I can actually, since I'm logged into this account, I can go and actually work on it right here. So that's an option you don't see in a lot of different whiteboards where things work that well. Now, the other thing that I really like is PDFs. I'm gonna grab this PDF right here. I could import it, but if I just drag it over, and I can do this with images too, just drag things in. And now I'm gonna zoom out. This was a multiple page PDFs here that it got brought in here with the image, and you can see that there's different text on it as well. So it's that quick on how it worked. So try with importing different things with the links on it and dragging different things to see what works best for you. You want quick access to a timer? FigJam's got you covered. Take a look in the top left, timer, music, and voting. I'm gonna click on this. pick, you can add minutes to the three already here, but you can just type in what you want. So if you wanted a 2-minute and 30-second timer, go ahead, do that. We have a volume level up here because you can pick a music to go along with the timer. So if we wanted to say it's Friday, we can go ahead, start our timer, start our music, and away it goes. So I can go and stop this here. I'm just gonna close this down. So a quick access to that. The last thing I wanted to show you today is the templates, and the templates are great because there's a lot of them. I love the design that they have. They're clean looks, fun looks to it. We have where you can search through these different categories here. So if I say for the classroom, take a look at the different options that you have for any of these ones, from voting ones to circle map process. So I can go and maybe add this template. As soon as I add it, it's going to be there. So we can zoom up if we need to be writing anything, or if you have multiple people writing in these. So these templates saves you a lot of time organizing and creating them on your own. People can just go and add their ideas to the sticky notes, and then you could do the votes that I showed you before. On the other side, there is, if you look over here, they give you some quick tips as well. So there's lots of templates that you can use. These are great that you can be looking for. Also, you can go see in the community for more. Again, when you're all done, don't forget to name your different ones that you're working with. And then you can go back to all your files. So if you want to go back to files, it shows you what you've just been working on. So here's a couple that I've been working on today. So you have access all the time just by simply logging in and trying them. So I hope you like this kind of this walkthrough of FigJam. I'm kind of excited about this product, especially with Jamboard leaving. I just find this has so many more options than Jamboard and a lot more fun and easy to share. So give FigJam a try. Let me know when you have tried it down in the comments, how it's working for you and some different ideas maybe that you've tried with it. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.